Hello everyone, my name is Arya Ajay Kudsarkar and I am a legal intern in Lexis & Company. I am also a 4th year BLB student GR Curriculum of Law, Margao, Goa and the Goa University. And today I am going to be talking on the topic of maintenance of wife, children, parents under section 125 of CRPC. And the purpose of making this video is to spread awareness about the maintenance provisions for wife, children and parents. Under section 125 CRPC provides order of maintenance of wife, children and parents if any person having sufficient means neglects or refuses to maintain his wife unable to maintain herself or his illegitimate legitimate minor child whether marriage or not unable to maintain itself or his legitimate or illegitimate child not being a married daughter who has attained majority where such a child is by reason of any physical or mental abnormality or injury unable to maintain itself or his parents or mother unable to maintain himself or herself. A magistrate of the first class may, upon proof of such neglect or refusal, order such person to make a monthly allowance for the maintenance of his wife or such child, father and mother at such monthly rate as such magistrate thinks fit and to pay the same to such person as a magistrate may from time to time direct, provided that the magistrate may order the father of the minor female child referred to it clause B to make such allowance until she attains her majority. The magistrate is satisfied that the husband of such minor female child is married, is not in possession of sufficient means. Explanation: for the purpose of this chapter, minor means a person who under the provisions of the Indian Majority Act 1875 is deemed to have attained his majority. Wife includes a woman who has been divorced by or has obtained a divorce from her husband and has not remarried. Such allowance shall be payable from the date of the order or if ordered from the date of application for maintenance. If any person so ordered fails without sufficient cause to comply with the order, any such magistrate may, for every breach of the order, issued a warrant for levy the amount due to the manor provided for levying fines and may sentence such person for the whole or any part of the month's allowance remaining unpaid after the execution of warrant to imprisonment for a term which may extend to 1 month or until payment if sooner made. Provided no warrant shall be issued for recovery of any amount due under this section unless application be made to the court to levy amount within a period of 1 year from the date of on which it becomes due. Provided further that if such person offers to maintain his wife or condition of her living with him and she refuses to live with him, such magistrate may consider any ground of refusal stated by her and may make on order under this section notwithstanding such offer if he is satisfied that there is just ground for doing so. Explanation: if a husband has contracted marriage with another woman or keeps a mistress, it shall be considered to be just ground for his wife's refusal to live with him. No wife shall be entitled to receive any allowance from her husband under this section if she is living in adultery or if without any sufficient reason she refuses to live with her husband or if they are separated by mutual consent. On proof that any wife in whose favor an order has been made under this section in living in adultery or that without sufficient reason she refuses to live with her husband or that they are living separately by mutual consent, the magistrate shall cancel the order. Please do like, share, subscribe and comment on my video and please do like, share, subscribe on our channel XClick and make sure to press the bell icon when you post a new video. Also, please give me your feedback on this video and the previous videos which you can see on this YouTube channel. Also, if you have any questions related to this video and previous videos, please post it in the comment section below. I will reply as soon as possible. Lastly, this video is also in depth promotion and advertisement as per the guidelines of the Bar Council of India and the sole purpose of making this video is for educational purposes only. Thank you.